short prenatal sequence that you can do during your pregnancy at any time, all the way up to full term. And you can even practice this if you are suffering with pelvic pain. So make sure before you begin you have a blanket and a bolster. If you don't have a bolster, you can use a pillow or two pillows, or even a couple of cushions. So once you grab those things, just come to sit on your mat. Make your spine nice and long, and then close your eyes. We just take a few breaths to bring ourselves into our practice. As you breathe in, just feel that brand new breath flowing through the body. As you exhale and release, let the shoulders soften. Just a couple more breaths. And then blink your eyes open a few times. And just come to stand at the very front of your mat. So you take it easy as you come up. And just bring your feet to hip distance apart. Make sure you're standing comfortably. So if you do have pelvic pain, your feet shouldn't go wider than your hips. If you don't have any pelvic pain, you might like to take your feet a tiny bit wider. Basically, we're making space for bump as we forward bend. Stand nice and tall, looking straight forward. And then take a very slow dip down. So the knees bend, toes are pointing forward. You should still be able to see your toes. So you're in a chair position. As you inhale, bring the arms halfway up and lift your gaze. And as you exhale, sit down a little lower. From here, take a little tuck of the pelvis so you actually straighten out the lower back as if you're pushing the lower back backwards, and then sit a little bit lower if you can. The legs should be firing up and working now. If you want to take this a little bit further, you can lift the arms a little higher. And if it's too strong, hands can come into prayer. Keep the breath flowing. Soft shoulders. And with your inhale, draw the arms to your sides, stand up tall. And with your exhale, release completely. Now tuck the chin down onto the chest. Let the shoulders roll forward, and we're going to start to roll down into our forward bend. So bend the knees when you're ready to. Make sure you've got space for bump. So if bump hits your left, you might just want to take the feet a tiny bit further apart. And just hang forward. Maybe hold the elbows, whatever feels most comfortable. Keep the breath flowing, make sure you've got some space for bump. Soften the shoulders, maybe giving them a little wiggle. And then draw up the hands, and with your inhale, roll up to standing. Maybe you need a couple of breaths. And roll the shoulders back. So let's do one more of those, starting from chair. So standing very tall, nice straight spine. With the inhale, arms come up all at once, this time sitting into your chair. Tuck the pelvis under, nice straight back. Breathe through the nose. Inhale to stand, exhale release, chin to chest, and roll down slowly. Catch the hands or elbows, put more space in the feet if you need it, and find to bend the knees. This time, bend the knees enough that you can press your hands or fingertips onto the mat, and then take one knee at a time backwards so you can come onto all fours. If you find it uncomfortable to be on your knees, you might like to use your rolled blanket. Just place that underneath your knees. And then let your hands come directly underneath your shoulders. Try to keep your back nice and straight here. And then let your gaze come directly downwards, so you're not lifting the head and straining the neck. From here we're going to come into cat pose. We're going to lift the back into a big dome. Look towards your belly. And then see if you can lift even further, making a big hunch like an angry cat. Keep the breath moving. One more breath. And then release the spine. And come forward to puppy. So the hands reach forward. And then slowly bring the hands close together and let the elbows come down. You might need to open your knees a tiny bit wider. And then from here, slowly place the head down, but keep your hips nice and high. You should feel a nice stretch along the back. Some opening through the shoulders. Two more breaths. And slowly lift up. Take your time. Hands come underneath the shoulders. And then from here, we're going to sit back onto our heels. So if that's comfortable to do as you are here, that's great. But if you don't feel too comfortable, or if you're getting discomfort through the legs or the pelvis, use your blanket and just roll it a couple of times so you've got a good thickness, and then place the blanket underneath your bottom and on top of those calves. From here, lengthen the spine so you're sitting really tall. You can inhale and lift the arms up, then exhale and twist one way. Look over that shoulder at the back and just use your hands against your thigh for an extra rotation. Try to keep the spine nice and long so we're not leaning here. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, twist. Just two breaths. And then gently release, come back into the centre. Exactly the same on the other side. So you're going to take a big inhale, lift up, and then exhale, twist. Inhale, long spine, exhale, twist. Inhale, arms up, come into the center. And exhale, release completely. Now we're a side stretch. We're just going to lift up one arm, it doesn't matter which side. Inhale, lift the arm. Exhale, come over until you feel a nice stretch down the whole side body. Soften this bottom shoulder. And then try to lift your gaze slightly up. Maybe you can look at your fingertips. If you have any dizziness, just keep looking slightly down. Find a focus point for the eyes. On the next inhale, come up, both arms up, and exhale, other side. Remember to soften this shoulder, it has a tendency to creep up. A nice stretch of the side body all the way down. Then find your gaze point, maybe it's that top lean back very slowly, and then as you inhale, puff the chest up and lift your gaze up. And if that feels really easy, we're going to go one step further and bring the hands flat to the floor and lift the bottom up, but only if that feels comfortable. Lift the bottom right up, breathe. Try to open through the chest and lift the chin. Two more breaths. Just lift your blanket or pillow, cushion, whatever you're using, out of the way. Grab your blanket or your pillow. And this time, we're going to sit on the bolster or pillow. So put that bolster or pillow lengthways and then just kneel over it. Make yourself really comfortable here. I'm just going to do a very short mindful breathing practice. When we use the breath to really focus our awareness. So get comfortable, hands into a cup, or maybe you're resting your hands on baby. Close your eyes. And now focus completely on your breath. As you breathe in, feel the breath coming up and along the back. As you breathe out, feel the tension seeping away from the shoulders. The shoulders drop downward. If you feel any tension in the lower back, just tuck the pelvis under you by lifting the bottom and then placing it back down. So lift, tuck, and sit. Inhale, the breath comes up and along the back like a massage. Exhale, the tension releases. And just stick with this breath. Very simple, mindful breath. To release tension from the back. As you do this, release any tension from your face. From your arms. And focus entirely on your breath. So your full awareness is right here, right now. Now drop your chin down to your chest. Blink the eyes open a few times. And gently lift the head. Namaste. This brings us to the end of our yoga practice, and I hope you've enjoyed this short prenatal sequence. Thanks very much for joining.